The moon trading strategy. Imagine having a strategy that worked from the start of time until now. If you want a strategy like this, then watch this video because I'm about to share with you a strategy that literally worked from the start of time. Now, when I initially heard about the moon trading strategy years ago, I immediately laughed very hard and then forgot completely about it. But then just today, after literally years of having more experience in trading, I do realize that most of the time, actually the most simple and really stupid trading ideas actually have the best performance. And that is why I just recently gave the moon trading strategy a shot. Now, before we actually get any further, when we thought about it just a little bit more, it actually made a lot of sense, because I remember years ago, maybe 2 years ago, I read a study that they did about the full moon effect, and they found out that the crime rate dramatically increases during the full moon, and the injury, so the hospital visits, increases a lot more in the full moon week as well. And even me, myself, whenever I feel not myself, so I feel upset, maybe I feel a little bit depressed, or that usual emotion, uncomfortable emotion that we feel inside of our chest from time to time, so you feel like you are triggered, or you basically have a negative emotions inside, well, 9 out of 10 times I find out that we are currently in the full moon week. So not exactly in the full moon day, but within 3 days before or after the full moon. And the reason is, in the study that I read, they mentioned that the full moon, when the full moon happens, the moon becomes closer to us, and therefore the gravity of it increases. And that have a lot of effects, including the waves motion in the ocean. And also, one of the effects is our blood cycle, because when the gravity of the moon increases dramatically during the full moon, then it will affect the natural flow of our blood cycle, and that will mess up our emotion as well. And when our emotion gets messed up, then it will be reflected in our trading performance. And that is the whole idea about why the moon trading strategy had worked from the start of time until now. So without further ado, let's roll in the intro and then get right into it. Hello again, traders. This is AJ here, the founder of Pro Trading University and AJ Capital Management. And because the moon trading have been with us for 30, 40 years back, it's considered to be one of the classical trading strategies. And therefore, we have a lot of information about it. The first step we did, therefore, was to simply Google moon trading strategy. And the first result I got was this trading article. And the basic trading strategy is actually very, very simple. We buy on the new moon and then sell on the full moon. So we are always in the market. We buy whenever we have the new moon, and that will last for 2 weeks until the full moon happens. And then we close our sell position, and then we open a buy position until the new moon. So in this chart right here, the full moon is the red circle. And I understand that during the full moon, we transform into wolves with red eyes. And that is why the full moon is a red circle. That's how you should remember it too. And the white circles, the empty circles, is the new moon. Because in the new moon, we cannot see anything, so it's an empty or white circle. So the trading idea is basically, again, to sell on the full moon and we buy on the new moon. So this is the new moon, we buy and we hold our buy position until we get the new moon, and we sell right here and we hold our position until the next new moon, and so on and so forth. So we are always going to be in the market. We are either buying or selling depending on where are we. Are we in the full moon or the new moon? So I basically wrote a very simple trading EA or a trading robot. It literally took me less than 5 minutes to write this down. And results of it, so the initial results of this strategy, let's make sure, first of all, yeah, we buy into the full moon and we sell into the new moon, for example, in dollar CAD. But before we go any further, the moon trading strategy, the way that we chose to develop it is to actually not use the walk forward optimization or the walk forward test method, because the moon effect have been always here from the start of time until now, and it didn't change and it will not change in the future, and therefore we shouldn't have a parameters that we optimize and re-optimize every year, because the effect is staying exactly the same way that the moon is affecting us right now. It's the same way the moon was affecting us 50 years ago. And therefore, we chose to take all of the available history data in the market. And that's why we started from the year 2000. And we are going to stop until the end of the year 2018. We're not going to stop to today. We are right now in July 11 in 2019, and therefore we can take the final rules and the trading system that we came up with and then test that on the virtual forward test data that we saved, and therefore we don't have to actually wait for months to come into the future to test the trading system in a forward test. Anyway, so let us see how the performance looks like with the basic initial idea that we actually got from the internet. And in Aussie dollar, for example, the performance will look like, hey, this is the equity curve in Aussie dollar. We are buying into the new moon and we are selling into the full moon. And this is the performance, not good, let me say that. Let's see, in pound dollar, I wouldn't say it is a good performance. You have to disregard this period. You want to take into account the overall performance, all of the 18 years we are testing. We want to see a consistent behavior, that an equity curve going up always. Let's see dollar CAD. And in dollar CAD, not that bad. It's just this period right here. But again, we wouldn't consider this. But now let us actually go to the SPY, which is the S&P 500. It's the US market. And here it is. And right here, we don't actually have the full history imported into MetaTrader. So here's the equity curve if we actually trade this in the SPY. And this actually only is from 2013. We can import the full history later. Now in the gold, for example, let's see the gold and finish there. So here's the gold. And in the gold, here is the equity curve performance. And as you see, I didn't waste hours and hours of time in doing the backtest, because I only spent 5 minutes in writing this simple code, and then I can have all of the backtest by a single click of a button, instead of going right here and going to the charts and going back 20 years in every pair and wasting hours and hours of time. So what I decided to do right now is to do a very simple change, and basically we are going to sell into the new moon and we are going to buy into the full moon. We are simply going to flip the strategy upside down. And now let us look at the performance. In gold, here's the performance in gold. We should have a good equity curve, not that bad. And really, we can take a flat period. We can take a slightly going up period. And this is the only thing that we don't want, but it happened, I think, in the year 2000. No, it happened in 2011. So anyway, it's a very short period, but it was huge. And let's look at the SPY, the US 500. Here is the performance. And wouldn't you look at that? And actually, when I saw this performance, this is when I decided that, hey, this trading strategy do have an edge in it. And probably I will end in adding the moon trading strategy to my own portfolio and in the portfolio for the fund that we manage in AJ Capital Management. So here is the performance of the SPY. Now let us go actually to the Forex pair. For example, the Aussie dollar was doing really bad, so it should be doing kind of well. It is still not acceptable right here. What about bond dollar? Let's see, bond dollar. So in bond dollar, it's still not acceptable. Anyway, so that was step number two, where we simply flipped the strategy upside down. Now, at this stage, we actually started to logically think about it ourselves and not take what we got online in how usually the moon trading strategy is being done. So we thought about it and we said, hey, the effect of the moon, for example, when I analyzed myself, whenever I didn't feel well, I was always within 3 days of the full moon. So I'm either 1 day ahead of the full moon or 2 days after the full moon. And we took from that is the effect of the full moon is not continuous. And therefore, we shouldn't always be in the market. We should limit our trade to be a specific number of days. So buying the full moon after 3 days, close the trade. But I'm not going to take the 3 days number based on my own experience, but instead I'm going to let the market tell me how many number of days I should keep the trade open. So here's what we did. We used the same trading system code right here. We just added a few lines of code, and basically it is saying that, hey, we are going to sell in the new moon and we are going to buy the new moon, but we are going to close our sell position when we opened it in the new moon after a specific number of days. And we are going to close our buy position when we buy the full moon after a specific number of days. And these two a number of days for the buy and sell are not going to be the same. So we did that, and therefore we have right now two parameters to optimize. For example, right now we are in the bond dollar. Let's choose the final version that we came up with so far, which is going to be this one right here. And therefore we have two parameters: how many days we should keep our buy position open and how many days we should keep our sell position open. And we are going to start, hey, with 1 day at step of one and end of 30. So we are going to test the parameters from 1 day to 30 days, and we are going to see which one did the best. And the best way actually to do it is to optimize the buy side alone and then optimize the sell side alone after that. But right now, because we want to save some time, we decided to do them both, but that is not the ideal way. So let's say okay, and then we hit the optimization button, and then we simply start. And in 9 seconds, we are going to have 900 of optimization results. So here are the results sorted from the combination that made the most profit to the lowest. And in the optimization graph, we can't really see anything right here. Not in this case. Anyway, so we are going to go with the one that makes most sense, and we shouldn't go with this, even though it made the most profit. But when we compare the profit compared to the maximum drawdown, we have a 50,000 maximum drawdown here, and we have made 194,000 of profit. But in this combination, we actually made about half of the maximum drawdown, and we kind of made actually the same amount of profit. So this is a lot better. So very quickly, we are going to choose this combination right now, but later when we actually do it the right way, we should also make sure that this combination is in the middle of a good combination, so it's not right on the edge. It's a little bit advanced for now. Anyway, we are going to use this combination, and we are going to see the equity curve of it, and voila, a very smooth equity curve that goes from the year 2000 all the way to right now, end of 2018, and we actually ended up with a new equity high. And at this stage, we can actually consider that we are done, because this equity curve is actually very smooth. I mean, these periods are actually going to be normal. And not only that, you are not only going to trade the pound dollar in this trading system, but you are probably going to trade a lot of pairs, including the US market, including the gold. And therefore, we can actually consider, hey, what if this is going to be our final version? And right now, just in the purpose of showing you in the video, then the forward test of this will be from January 1st in 2019 all the way to July 11th of 2019. It's around 6 months and 11 days right here. And therefore, we are considering right now that, hey, we did all of the optimization, all of the finalization of the trading system, and right now it's time to actually see the virtual forward test results. And I'm actually don't remember what was it, but not bad. The profit factor is 1.8, a profit factor of 1.8. come on, man, this is obviously have an edge in it. The moon trading strategy, whoever thought that a moon trading strategy will be traded in my fund? Anyway, this is a pound dollar. Let's do actually I don't know, let's do Aussie dollar. If we do Aussie dollar, we are going to optimize right here all the way going back to the year 2000, and we are going to optimize it to the end of the year 2018. Optimize, start. And once we actually come up with the parameters right here, then we are going to use them forever, because the moon effect will stay the same. It will not change in the future. So the optimization results, we are going to actually right here, well, let's for now use this combination. Let's see the equity curve. Maybe the equity curve. Yeah, I mean, the equity curve right here, it wasn't working. I mean, if we compare this to bond dollar, for example, the bond dollar was always going up. But in Aussie dollar, we have a period right here for how many years? For about 6 years that we weren't performing at all. But anyway, after further development, it might actually be worth it to add this pair to the overall portfolio of markets that we are going to trade with this strategy. And here's why. This Aussie dollar has been doing very well in this period and in this period, but in right here, it haven't. Other pairs, they might have the opposite performance. So they might have been performing very well right here, but right here, they are not performing very well. And if you combine multiple markets with different uncorrelated performances, then the overall performance will be very smooth and it will always go up. So we are still going to consider the Aussie dollar for now. So if we are going to go and see the virtual forward test of this pair right here of the Aussie dollar, then from January 2019 all the way to today, and here is the performance of the, not bad actually, not bad at all. And we have a profit factor of 1.79, so almost the same as the performance in bond dollar. And here you go, this is the stage where we reached in developing the moon trading strategy. And we do actually have a bit more ideas. For example, we see that, hey, a lot of the times we see whenever we have a full moon, then it will be a turning point in the market. For example, the full moon came right here. A few days after it, we went from bearish to bullish. And this theme has been going for some time. And same thing with the new moon. Right here we're going bullish, few days after the new moon we started to go bearish. It might have an edge right here, it might not, so we are going to test, hey, what if we go against the overall trend whenever we have a full moon or whenever we have a new moon, how the performance will look like. We are going to continue to develop this trading system until we actually finalize it and we trade it with real money. And we are going to continue to do that in the live room. And actually, we have been crushing it lately in the live room. We just put three different trading systems in the incubation phase that we developed together in the live room. And let's see the performance as of today. We didn't check that out yet. So it will be the 50 patterns EA, and it will be, okay, so the bond New Zealand. So there are three. So the first one was in bond New Zealand. Now they are named the same, but they are actually a different trading system for each pair. So bond New Zealand, this trading system only trades the bond New Zealand pair. And the virtual forward test started from the year 2019 January, but the real actual live test started from the year, or from year 2019, of course, but from June 20. So we have around 3 weeks right now of live test. And let's see the performance of it right now. Okay. Not bad. I'm pretty sure that, I am confident 100% that this trading system will be included in our overall portfolio in our fund, AJ Capital Management, and we are going to add it on August 20. Assuming that nothing happens, we continue this performance until August 20 of the year 2019, we are going to trade this with real money. If we look at the virtual result, the virtual forward test starting from the year 2019, then here is the result. And overall, we are currently in line with the overall performance. So that is the first trading system we put in incubation. And the second will be actually bond dollar. Let's see bond dollar. How is bond dollar doing right now? We actually took it from the beginning. Not too bad. We are in profit overall. let's see the actual live forward test, which will start from June 20. This is what I care about the most. Actually, pretty good. A profit factor of 1.21, and we have that. And I believe that in the next maybe 2 to 3 live room sessions, we are going to finalize the trading moon trading system, and we are going to put it in the incubation phase maybe in 2 weeks from now. If you want to join the live room, if you want to learn how to do all of this, if you want to have access to all, not to all, but to some of our trading systems, the trading systems that we trade live right now in our own money and in the money of the clients that we manage, then down below in the description box, there's a link of a limited free trial if you want to take an advantage of. If you want to join our team for a free trial, you will literally have to pay $0. You will not pay anything to join our team in a free trial. Then click down the link below and I will see you in the live room. And to conclude this video, as always, don't let anyone tell you what you can or cannot do. Prove them wrong and keep going.